The songs really fell into two categories on the album. They were sort of either the experimental ones, which sort of came around in a sort of more bitty way, but this What If was a sort of more traditional sort of song in the sense that Chris wrote the whole thing on a piano and showed us the whole song, and there was nothing left to do, and it was just a case of just then sort of working on it as a band and writing sympathetic parts for it, and that it was, you know, it was really quite a quick process.
And no reason or rhyme.
X and Y is a three-pronged title. It relates to the mathematical imagery, and we're all fascinated by algebra, and within algebra, the way that X and Y are always used to represent figures or quantities that no one actually knows. Then it was all to do with there being two sides to everything, X and Y, and dark and light and good and bad, because it seems to me that everything relies upon the tension of opposites, and, you know, I was wondering why every day was such a mixture of extreme excitement and terrible worry. Then I thought, well, maybe it's because that's how life works. And so X and Y felt very apt on that level, and also it's X and Y like man and woman. So there we go.
Chris's fascination with polarity could arguably mirror his own oscillating personality, swinging from self-effacing pessimist to self-assured frontman. In solo experiments, Chris unites two different musical worlds, collaborating with Jay-Z and Kanye West.
Yeah. And you say Shy City, Shy City, Shy City.
I'm coming home again. Do you think about me now and then?
Yeah.
Do you think about me now and then? Cause I'm coming home again. Oh.
You know, I think some of the things Chris has done with Kanye and Jay have been, you know, really good actually, and it's really very flattering for us that they would, you know, want to work with Chris. I think it's brilliant.
It's also good because you're exposed to a different way of making music. You know, the way we make music and the way hip-hop is made is probably quite different, but equally wonderfully valid. And so if we can gain any insights into how to do something different, then it's a really useful experiment.
Maybe do you remember when fireworks at Lake Michigan? Maybe we could start again.
The theme of opposites carried right through to Coldplay's fourth album, Viva la Vida, or Death and All His Friends, inspired by the band's 2007 tour to South America.
It was a long and dark December.
Well, the title, which we've had for a long time, Viva la Vida, came from a Frida Kahlo painting. We were on tour in South America, and Chris discovered Frida's work, and we kind of almost decided there and then that the album was going to be called that.
It's not forcing you to choose what the title is. It just kind of represents the two different possible readings of the album. You know, one is quite up and happy, and the other is a little bit more melancholy.
The band enlisted the help of Brian Eno, best known for his work with David Bowie, Talking Heads, and U2.
Brian is a man who is just full of ideas. I think the chances of him suggesting to other people to do the same ideas as he's, you know, been suggesting to us is very remote, you know.
Unlikely.
He's a man that gets very bored very quickly, and he's always sort of searching for the next thing, so there was no fear of any sort of overlap with anyone else he might be working with at the moment.
The first single, Violet Hill, was downloaded 600,000 times from the band's official website in the first 24 hours.
Well, interestingly, Violet Hill was a song which is now our first single. It's hard to describe it really, because I suppose it's really a song about, you know, about authority, really.
I think it's escaping authority. It's probably what it's about. That's what it is to me.
The album has been described as a new direction for Coldplay, a change from their past three, which they have referred to as a trilogy.
This time around, we felt like we had to be brave. We released three albums that we're very, very proud of, but I think we felt that we couldn't really take that any further in trajectory, you know, without it becoming a bit overblown. It was a conscious effort to make brave decisions. We wanted to make sure there was nothing on there that was safe and comfortable and that felt like we'd done before.